Justin, and marriage is a bond to be entered into only after considerable thought and reflection. It is that most fragile relationship and the strongest. It is fragile because it requires the right mix of freedom and of interdependence, of caring and of sharing, of being together and of being alone. As with any aspect of life, it has its cycles, its ups, its downs, its trials and triumphs. And with full understanding of this, Cory and Justin have come here today to be joined as one in marriage. Remember that this wedding is only a symbol, a celebration, a public recognition of what already exists in the silent places of your hearts. It is your marriage and not something created by the state of the church. It's yours to define, yours to make real, and it's yours to live. Nothing I can say can make it anything more than already exists in your hearts. The Bible in 1 Corinthians describes love this way. Love is patient, love is kind, and envies no one. Love is never boastful, nor conceited, nor rude. Never selfish, and not quick to take offense. Love keeps no score of wrongs, does not gloat over other people's sins, but delights in the truth. There are no limits to its faith, its hope, and its endurance. In a word, there are three things that last forever. Faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of all is love.
Hi, Justin. I offer myself to you as your husband for all eternity. I will love, honor, and cherish you above all others. I promise to be there for you when you need me, to be your strength when your spouse is. to inspire you with courage and true thought, to walk side by side, step by step, for our great journey together, beginning here and now, faithfully, from this day forward.
I, Cory, offer myself to you as your wife for all eternity. I will love, honor, and cherish you above all others. I promise to be there for you when you need me.